Hello and welcome. I have a question for you. Have you ever heard of Intel's T-Class CPUs? You've very likely come across them over the years if you are a home lab kind of person who has purchased HP EliteDesk, Lenovo ThinkCenter, and Dell Optiplex. A T-Class CPU is a CPU that has been hardlocked to PL, one value of 35 watts. PL2 value differs depending on its core count, but the sustained power is always set to mere 35 watts. There is no exception to this no matter how many cores a T-Class CPU has. For example, core i9-14900T CPU will be locked to 35 watts in spite of having 24 cores. How does it work, and why do such CPUs exist? Well, T-Class CPUs are a legacy of the past. They were created in an era where downclocking CPUs wasn't as easy as now. Because Intel does the job of downclocking CPUs, OEMs have found it easy to install them in small form factor PCs and sell them as office computers without doing much on their end. Because the downclocking is done on a hardware level, even if BIOS resets due to some electronical shock or CMOS battery dies, it's not going to overheat. In that sense, T-Class CPUs have its own niche place even in 2025. AMD does have equivalent of this. They are GE-class CPUs. But their implementation of it is limited to APU, whereas Intel has a T-Class counterpart to almost every CPU SKU. And, because they are not as widely available as Intel's T-Class CPUs, its price isn't worth it. T and GE class CPUs are OEM only, meaning they are sold in a tray of 1,000 at the minimum. When an office upgrades their office computers, these T class CPUs are extracted and dumped on eBay and other e-commerce websites. This means that they are usually cheaper than its retail counterparts. It's not always true, but some common models are real bargains. If you search the right SKU at the right time, you can score really nicely. All right, let's talk about the CPU you are seeing right now. It is Core i5-13600T. It is a 13th gen Intel CPU with Alder Lake core. You can tell which 13th and 14th gen are Alder Lake by looking at RAM speed they support. If it supports DDR5-4800, it's the 12th gen core. Anyway, this CPU at 35 watts is as powerful as 12600K CPU, which is rated at 125 watts under one condition. As long as the T CPU is not pushed at 100% load, the 35 watts limit is too much of a constraint, and this is where the point of T-Class CPU stands. As long as a T-Class CPU does not push itself to max, it is seemingly as good as its desktop counterpart. I scored this for just $125. With shipping and tax included, I ended up paying $166 for it, which translates to CA$230. And 12,600K costs around CA$280 at the moment, shipping and tax included. The saving is pretty decent, and here is something interesting. You can easily alter PL one of the T CPU. In doing so, the 13600T ends up outperforming 12600K. How you overclock a T CPU is really simple. You just change the PL one value. That is all it takes. If you are a deal seeker, you may see good potentials for bang for the buck at this point. There is a caveat to this, however. Since you need offices to dump their PCs, you will be generally one or two generations behind if you want real bargains. I am showing you right now how to overclock a T CPU. You just change PL1 value, and that is it. You may want to set PL2 value equal or higher than PL1 value meanwhile, just to avoid any glitches. As you can see, PL1 and PL2 have been set to 125 watts. But does it actually push to that limit? We are about to find out. In my opinion, the best way to measure raw strength of CPU is rendering. Therefore, I am going to render a Blender file I've created. I will compare the completion time between this and at PL 135 watts, and then with 12600K CPU. So, the completion time is 14 minutes and 52 seconds. I am going to render the same file again, but PL1 set at the default 35 watts. Let's see how that goes. I wager it's going to take much longer to complete it. Well, the completion time is 26 minutes and 20 seconds. I knew it was going to be worse, but it's a lot worse than I expected. It's almost 100% slower. Now, let's see how 12600K does at its default PL setting. 16 minutes and 16 seconds. So, an overclocked 13600T is slightly faster. Perhaps it's not unexpected given the fact that it does have 4 more E cores. Core by core, they are probably equal, almost. It's time to move on to closing words. So, let's get some facts first. First of all, I purchased 13600T CPU for $125 from eBay. With shipping and tax, the total came to $166, which translate to roughly 230 Canadian rubles. A 12600K CPU costs $280 right now in April of 2025. I wouldn't brag that it's a huge bargain, but $50 is nothing to scoff at, especially in this economy. A T-class CPU is very easy to overclock. As long as BIOS allows manual setting for PL1 and PL2, you can overclock it with ease. I am unsure whether 610 chipset allows this, but 660 and 760 chipsets do allow it, and there are a plethora of cheap 660 and 760 motherboards out there. You could assemble a very inexpensive but capable PC with the right combination. Meanwhile, I must tell you that prices of T-class CPUs fluctuate a lot. Do not expect to find bargain deals right away. It requires some efforts and time on your end to find a really good deal. A cash-strapped seller might accept an offer that is otherwise refused, for example. Looking at the market right now, it looks like 12400T is in the sweet spot of being really cheap. If you are willing to pay a bit more, 13500T seems to be a good bang for the buck as well. I believe I've said this before. In my humble opinion, overclocking is dead. I stand by this still. Overclocking is dead for the majority of consumer CPUs. But T-class CPU is the exception. Because its factory power limit is set to so low, you can easily overclock this and get so much more out of it. I got almost 100% boost out of 13600T CPU, for example. This is the sort of overclocking PC enthusiasts used to get a few decades ago. This is why I purchased T-class CPU. Granted, I don't get to buy the latest CPUs, but I am generally not interested in the newest stuff because, unfortunately for me, money matters. Thankfully, I am not a gamer, so I don't need to buy those ridiculously priced GPU. Well, anyway, thank you for watching this T-class CPU explained video. See you next time, hopefully.